So, who's this? No problems. Okay. Let's go back. So, I did see. 100%. I was ready to listen. It was only 54 minutes.
Okay, so with the Speechify app, you can just paste any link, any article from the web, and then you just put it into this app, and then you can listen to it. Oh, it's only 5 minutes.
When I reflect on the past 2 decades of computer science research, few things inspire me more than the remarkable progress we've seen in the field of artificial intelligence. In 2001, some colleagues sitting just a few feet away from me at Google realized they could use an obscure technique called machine learning to help correct misspelled search queries. I remember I was amazed to see it work on everything from IMDb Recording hundreds of millions of people within their flooding bunker. 20 years of advances in research have helped elevate AI from a promising idea to an indispensable aid in billions of people's daily lives. And for all that progress, I'm still excited about its yet untapped potential. AI is poised to help humanity confront some of the toughest challenges we've ever faced. From persistent problems like illness and inequality to emerging threats like climate change, imagine the depth and complexity of those urgent challenges will require new, more capable AI systems. Systems that can combine AI's proven approaches with NASA research directions to be able to solve problems we are unable to solve today. To that end, teams across Google Research are working on elements of a next-generation AI architecture we think will help realize such systems. Pathways is a new way of thinking about AI that addresses many of the weaknesses of existing systems and synthesizes their strengths. To show you what I mean, let's walk through some of AI's current shortcomings and how Pathways can improve upon them. Today's AI models are typically trained to do only one thing. Pathways will enable us to train a single model to do thousands or millions of things. Today's AI systems are often trained from scratch for each new problem. The mathematical model's parameters are initiated literally with random numbers. Imagine if, every time you learn a new skill, jumping rope, for example, you forgot everything you'd learned, how to balance, how to leap, how to coordinate the movement of your hands, and started learning each new skill from nothing. That's more or less how we train most machine learning models today. Rather than extending existing models to learn new tasks, we train each new model from nothing to do one thing and one thing only, or we sometimes specialize a general model to a specific task. The result is that we end up developing thousands of models for thousands of individual tasks. Not only does learning each new task take longer this way, but it also requires much more data to learn each new task. Since we're trying to learn everything about the world and the specifics of that task from nothing, completely unlike how people approach new tasks, instead, we'd like to train one model that can not only handle many separate tasks, but also draw upon and combine its existing skills to learn new tasks faster and more effectively. That way, when a model learns by training on one task, say, learning how aerial images can predict the elevation of landscape, could help it learn another task, say, predicting how floodwaters will flow through that terrain. We want the one model to have different capabilities that can be called upon as needed and stitched together to run more capable, complex tasks. A bit closer to the way the mammalian brain generalizes across tasks.
That's true.
Multiple senses to perceive the world. That's very different from how contemporary AI systems digest information. Most of today's models process just one modality of information at a time. They contain new text, or images, or speech, but typically not all three at once. Pathways could enable multimodal models that encompass vision, auditory, and language understanding simultaneously. So whether the model is processing the word leopard, the sound of someone saying leopard, or a video of a leopard running, the same response is activated internally. The concept of a leopard. The result is a model that's more insightful and less prone to mistakes and biases. And of course, the AI model uniquely restricted to these familiar senses. Pathways that handle more abstract words and data, helping find useful patterns that have eluded human scientists in complex systems such as climate dynamics. A third problem is that most of today's models are dense, which means the whole neural network activates to accomplish a task, regardless of whether it's very simple or really complicated. This, too, is very unlike the way people approach problems. We have many different parts of our brain that are specialized for different tasks, yet we only call upon the relevant pieces for a given situation. There are close to 100 billion neurons in your brain, but you rely on a small fraction of them to interpret this sentence. AI can work the same way. We can build a single model that is sparsely activated, which means only small pathways through the network are called into action as needed. In fact, the model dynamically learns which parts of the network are good at which tasks, and learns how to route tasks through the most relevant parts of the model. A big benefit to this kind of architecture is that it not only has a larger capacity to learn a variety of tasks, but it's also faster and much more energy efficient. Because we don't activate the entire network for every task. For example, SMART and Switch Transformer are two of the largest machine learning models we've ever created, but because both use sparse activation, they consume less than one-tenth the energy that you'd expect of similarly sized dense models, moving as accurate as dense models.
So should we play this again, guys, next year, same time? We can do this every year. I'd probably live 200 years this time.
Understanding in our world and yet adapting to needs. That last point is crucial. We're familiar with
Here's what I would say. I say the same thing every time. You suck, bitch. That's always my message. Or select other. when your mind breaks the spirit of your soul. Broken glass and the hangover doesn't pass. Built to last, you're in ruins. 121 guns. I write sins, not tragedies. Oh, well imagine. In a church corridor, and I can't help but to hear. An exchanging of words. What a beautiful wedding. What a beautiful wedding, says a bridesmaid. Is a whore. Chimed in with a habit you people ever heard of. Closing a goddamn door, no. With sense of poison rationality, I chimed in with a habit you people ever heard of. Closing a goddamn door, no. Tarek, we are married this city. For the champagne,
thank you.
killers.
Thank you. description and date the session.
Your final call.